Hello and Om Sai Ram, and welcome to the 10th episode of Sri Ram Vijay Granth lecture series. Yes, so after a break of one long week, we are again back with the most awaited 10th episode of Sri Ram Vijay Granth lecture series. My sincere apologies, first of all, for this long wait, and with the positive note that we are going to take up or deal with chapter 28, 29, and 30, which are the most interesting chapters of Sri Ram Vijay Granth lecture series. For we are going to know about the backgrounds of various incidents which we have been reading in the Ramayana. And as we have seen from the beginning, that the Ram Vijay Granth, although it is a small granth, yes, it deals widely with the Ramayana only, but the story being the same, the details are much more than that. So let's see what are the secrets that we are going to unveil today in front of our eyes in this episode. First of all, with a humble prostration to Sri Baba's lotus feet, we dedicate this presentation to him for his kind blessings and inspiration that we are able to continue with our series till now, and we trust that Baba will definitely bless us, and so that we can continue with this endeavor in future also, and may bring up more interesting pastimes of the Lord and many other books through this channel. Om Sai Ram. So now to begin with Adhyay 28. Till the last episode, what we saw is that the monkeys, the entire Vanar Sena, had reached the seashore. They were anxious. They were restless to cross the sea, to conquer Lanka, to kill Ravana, and to bring back Mata Sita. But that was not yet to be. It was a time-taking process, a gradual process which has to be well planned, and all the people, all the army needs to be patient for that. In Adhyay 28, the scene or the setup begins in such a way. The monkeys were anxious to cross the sea and go to Lanka, but they were unable to do so. Yes, because they had the vast ocean in front of them, or the sea, which separated them from Lanka. However, Maruti, repeating the name of Ram, crossed the sea. But on the way, he met with several accidents, or better to be called obstacles or hindrances. The gods, in order to test his valor, sent a huge woman to devour him. So Hanumanji himself also had undergone so many tests, and we are petty human beings. So now let us see how Lord Hanuman dealt with the various obstacles that were sent from the various sources while crossing the sea. She opened her mouth. Now this huge woman, she opened her mouth wide and stood in Hanuman's way. He passed through her mouth and proceeded further. In the meantime, Samudradev, or the sea, sent a mountain to block up his way. The mountain said to him, "Good creature, why are you not going to take rest on my bosom?" At these words, Maruti got enraged and pressed down the mountain. A little further, once again a frightful demoness, her name was Simhika. Now this Simhika was the mother of Rahu and Ketu. She swallowed him up. But again, Hanuman tore off her belly and came out. At last, he arrived upper Lanka, where the goddess of the place, caught hold of his legs and knocked him down. He got up and gave her mortal blows when she implored him to spare her life. He having granted her request that I spare your life, that goddess, she blessed him, saying that he would be successful in his undertaking. Then Hanuman proceeded to lower Lanka, which is also called Udalanka. Here, Krocha, she is the younger sister of Ravana, whose husband Gagar was killed by Indra. She lived there in the lower part of Lanka. So now, as soon as she was informed of Hanuman's arrival there, she went with a number of demons and demonesses to catch him. When Hanuman, he became a small and a beautiful animal. Now, Krocha, she said to the demons and demonesses that this is a very good and pretty animal. Let me have it for my breakfast. So demons always, they think of everything, anything and everything as their lunch and dessert. So just kill it and cook it for me. So now Hanumanji was in a confusion that she is trying to eat me up also. That is not possible. Now let me defend myself by my words. He was Atulit Baldhama, but besides that he was also Gyanagun Sagar. So he dealt with this situation with intellect. My body, replied Hanuman, is full of water. And if you order me to be cooked for your breakfast, you will get nothing. So Hanumanji said that I have no flesh in my body. It's fully consisting of water. If you cook me, you will just have water in your lunch. I therefore tell you to swallow me up so that you may have a delicious taste of mine. So the demoness, accordingly obeying Hanuman's request or orders, whatever you call it, swallowed up Maruti, who entered her heart and pulled off her flesh. So Hanumanji, after entering her body, attacked her heart. So the demoness now couldn't bear the pain, and she tossed him out again. She threw him out of her mouth. Her companions gave her medicine mixed with the clung of a hog. But the monkey, or Hanuman, precisely speaking, was so disgusted with the dirt inside her body that he let out his tail through her nose. So Hanuman was still, she was trying to bring him out, but he was still inside his body, inside his mouth, and his tail was hanging from her nose. Now, demoness believed that the tail was a disease, that what is this hanging from my nose? And she began to pull it out. When Maruti finally did his job, he tore off her belly, came out, and threw all the demons and demonesses into the sea. From lower Lanka, he again went to upper Lanka. And at sunset, he entered Nikumbala, a country in Lanka, where Indrajit, the eldest son of Ravan, lived with his family. He went into the palace of the demon prince and saw him with his beautiful wife Sulochana. So Indrajit and Sulochana both stayed in this particular room where Maruti was standing in front of. So Maruti now said to himself, no doubt this is Sita. She has fallen in love with this wicked demon. So now let me make one thing absolutely clear. Maruti or Lord Hanuman had not seen Sita yet. So he did not know about the, like how Mata Sita looked and whatnot. So he assumed that this is Sita, who had fallen in love with this wicked demon. this is not Ravana. He has confused Ravana with Indrajit again. So saying to himself, he was about to kill both of them. But in the meantime, this Sulochana, she said to her husband, just think for a moment. Is it not a bad thing that your father has unjustly brought Sita here? If she is not restored to her husband, a great calamity will befall him. Having heard this conversation, now Maruti was consoled that this is not Sita. He was convinced that no, neither is this Ravana nor this is Sita. I was making a mistake. So he again left this place. After this begins the 29th Adhyaya. So after visiting Indrajit's castle, from there he went to the palace of Vibhishan, the youngest brother of Ravana, where he was much pleased because the demon was a devotee of Lord Ram and everything there was so clean. He also saw there an idol of Lord Ram, which Vibhishan worshipped every day. Then from there he went to the palace of Kumbhakar, where he was in deep sleep, snoring all the time. Maruti was disgusted with the sight of the heaps of bones and flesh of human beings and animals scattered around his palace. So Kumbhakarna's palace was totally opposite to that of Vibhishan. Whereas Vibhishan was a devotee, he was a pure devotee of Lord Ram. Whereas on the other hand, this Kumbhakarna, as it is, he was sleeping and his palace was so dirty. So when he failed to find Sita there also and at other places, he was enraged now. But what is going on? Where is Mata Sita? And assuming an invisible form, now he became invisible. And he began to trouble the demons and demonesses of Lanka in various ways. When they carried water in their pots, he broke them with his tail. He dashed to pieces the chariots of the princes who happened to drive in the streets. So now he started doing some mischievous activities in order to explore the Lanka more better, in order to know about the places, the inmost secrets of the demons and demonesses, so that he could get any trace of Mata Sita. So he started doing these mishaps in the streets. One day, now one fine day, a barber began to shave the beard of Ravana. When Maruti did acute mischief, what he did was, Maruti stood behind this barber in an invisible form and thrust his tail into the hose of the nose of the barber. So now Hanumanji was standing behind him in an invisible form. Nobody was able to see him. The barber was doing his job of shaving Ravana's beard, and Hanumanji tickled his nose with his tail, with his divine tail. Prior to which, the barber was startled, and in a confusion that followed, he shaved the mustaches of Ravana. Now Ravana got very angry and slapped the barber in the face. Then the monkey also gave a slap to the demon king. Now Maruti pulled down the houses of the demons with his tail while their families were asleep. So now he started to kill the demons and do all sorts of activities which would bring a distress to the inhabitants of the entire Lanka kingdom, so that it draws the attention of Ravana that somebody is present here. So he did all the things that were necessary. One day, in a minute, he extinguished all the lamps in Lanka. And consequently, all of a sudden, everyone was in confusion and everyone was alarmed that something is wrong, because these things never happened before. So many accidents together in a single day, in a single minute, has never happened in Lanka. The inhabitants of Lanka said to themselves, Sita, whom Ravana has brought here, has created a devil, I think, to annoy and trouble us. So the people were discussing amongst themselves that this might be a demon created by Sita. Finally, after these things were done, Maruti then entered the palace of Ravana, where he and his wife Mandodari were fast asleep. Again, Hanumanji was confused. On seeing Mandodari, Maruti thought that she was Sita and she fell in love with the demon king. He got much enraged and was about to carry them where Rama was staying with Lakshman. That see, this might be your wife. She has fallen in love with this demon king, Ravana. Then he thought that no. Previously I made a confusion. Now let me just hear to what they are discussing. So Mandodari was awakened in alarm all of a sudden. And she said to her husband, I've dreamt a dream which indicates that Indrajit and you will be killed, that the Ashoka forest will be destroyed, and that Lanka will be burnt because you have unjustly brought Sita here. I therefore implore you to restore her to her husband. You need not be afraid of it in the least, replied Ravana. So on Mandodari's dream, which signified that her son, Indrajit and Ravana would be killed by Ram because Ravana has done a sin by carrying off Mata Sita, who was none other than Devi Lakshmi. So Ravana consoled her that you need not be afraid of this fact. I have posted 5 crores of the demons and demonesses to watch the Ashoka forest, and they will not allow Ram to kill us and destroy the forest. So saying, Ravana dispatched his servant to the Ashoka forest to see whether Sita was there. Now everyone was already in a state of shock at what is happening all around Lanka. The things are not at all in order. Now Maruti, he accompanied the servant in an invisible form. No one could see him. Now he thought that yes, so they have kept Mata Sita in the Ashoka forest. Let me follow the servant and let me find out this particular forest where Mata Sita is kept. The servant returned to Ravana and Maruti remained in the Ashoka forest. Ultimately, he found Mata Sita. With this ends chapter 20 and we begin with chapter 30 of this month. Now Hanuman was exceedingly glad when he found Sita and threw before Mata Sita the ring which Ram had put on his finger. If you remember, in the 9th episode we discussed widely about this ring. She looked at the ring and asked it with tears in her eyes, Ring, where have you come from? How is my Ram? Is he safe? While Sita was thus asking the ring, the demonesses came there and told her to keep quiet, saying that if she did not listen to them, they would kill her. When Maruti with his tail tied up all of them together and flung them down, some of them died and some fled from the place. He then began to sing Ramji's bhajan. Hanumanji started singing the praises of Ramji, which was so pleasing to hear that Mata Sita, after hearing that bhajan, she was very anxious to see who the creature was. Like, who is here? Who is singing Lord Ram's name? Who is chanting his name? She called several times, but nobody responded to her call. She was disappointed and prepared herself to commit suicide. Then Maruti came and stood before her. He bowed down to her, Mata Sita's lotus feet. She asked him, "Who are you? What is your name? And where have you come from?" Now Hanumanji introduces himself. "I am a servant of Ram and have come here in search of you," replied Maruti. "Your Ram is well and has come to Kishkindha for you. He will shortly take you from this place. You need not be afraid of me. I am not a demon. I am the Pavan Putra, the son of the wind, and my name is Maruti." "Besides that ring," continued Sita, "have you got any other proof from Ram that you are his servant?" Whereupon, he recapitulated all the calamities that had befallen her, and she was thereby convinced, after listening to Maruti, that he was her husband's very, very, very loyal devotee, a servant devotee. "I should have annihilated Lanka in a moment and taken you to Kishkindha," said Maruti. "But Ravana will not be killed by me, nor did Lord Ram order me to do so. I am very hungry, Mata. Will you therefore allow me to take fruits from the trees in the forest for my breakfast?" So now Mata Sita said, "It is not in my power to allow you to take fruits from this place," replied Sita. "And if you forcibly take them, the demons and demonesses will kill you. I, however, tell you to gather for your breakfast the fruits that have fallen on the ground and not to take them from the trees with your hands or feet." Now, Maruti, as we know, he was the incarnation of knowledge on earth. Hanumanji said, "Yes, yes, Mata, I swear that I shall not take any fruit from the trees with my hands and feet." He mentioned these two terms. "I shall take the fruits which have fallen on the ground." So saying, he lengthened his tail and plucked all fruits with it. He promised Mata Sita not to use his hands and legs to pluck the fruits. But who said he can't use the tail? So he started using his tail. And after a few minutes itself, he destroyed the whole of the Ashoka forest. The 60 crores of the demons who were watching the forest at once came upon him. But he tied them up with his tail and flung them down. Some died and some fled from that place. Hearing this news, Ravana sent 8,000 demons to catch the monkey, but all of them were tied up in a similar fashion with his tail and killed. Ravan was greatly enraged and sent 1 lakh of warriors, whom again Hanumanji threw into the sea with his tail. So I am highly emphasizing on the word tail, because he was not using his hands and legs to fight the battle at all. He was so strong. His tail was so strong. His mere tail was so strong. The demon king then sent his son Akshay with a large army. But he was also killed with the other sons. Immediately after, he dispatched a frightful demoness called Asali, who had the strength of 10,000 elephants. She opened her hideous mouth, which was 1 yojan in length and breath, and she ate up Lord Hanuman. But again Lord Hanuman tore her belly off and came out. At last, seeing this feat in this entire battlefield, Ravan sent his son Indrajit with a large army of demons. He let off arrows at Maruti, which Maruti broke off with his hands in no time. Maruti pulled off his entire rath with his tail and broke it, killed his horses. He took up an iron bar and went killing the demons with it when Indrajit attempted to catch him in a snare. But the monkey, or here Lord Hanuman, became as small as an atom and escaped through it every time the prince put upon him. So as many times he was attacked, he was not seen because he took the size of an atom, which was invisible to naked eyes. Whereupon Indrajit made a snare with a small nose and put it upon him. When he again assumed a large form and broke the snare. When the prince failed in catching him in the snare, he combated with Hanuman. But again he was flung down by him on the ground. Now Indrajit was alarmed and said to himself that if he was seized by the monkey and carried to Ram, he would be cruelly treated over there. So saying, he hid himself in a cave. Then again Maruti blocked up the mouth of it with a mountain. Indrajit cried and wept inside the cave. This ends chapter 30 of the Granth. In the next episode, we are going to see what happened after this. What were the next steps that Indrajit took in order to save Lanka, his father, and himself? And how he let off Brahmastra towards Lord Hanuman. So these three chapters widely dealt with Hanumanji's crossing the sea and coming to Lanka, then destroying Lanka like anything. Still destruction is just not even halfway. Lanka is yet to be destroyed. Just the forests were destroyed and many demons were killed. We saw that how Lord Hanuman met Mata Sita. Previously he confused that Indrajit's wife Sulochana and Ravan's wife Mandodari to be Sita. But when he saw Mata Sita, he understood at once that this must be Mata Lakshmi, the wife of none other than Ananta Koti Brahmanda Nayak Lord Ram. So with this note and the pastimes of Lord Ram, we conclude today's episode. And let us see in the next episode what happened next. Om Sai Ram. I thank all the audience for watching the video with utter patience and devotion. May Lord Ram and Sri Sainath Maharaj bless their blessings. They bestow their choicest blessings on you and your family. Om Sai Ram.